Okay, so in this short video, we're going to go over the income and substitution effect. These two effects will help us have a deeper understanding of a variety of different problems, including some that we'll go over in the active live session in class. So before I actually get into the income and substitution effects, I just want to quickly review exactly where we are review these indifference curve graphs, because we're going to need to use them quite extensively to understand the income and substitution effects. So let's quickly review this graph. On these graphs, we have the quantity that this person consumes of two different goods, good Y on the vertical axis and good X on the horizontal axis. And then we're going to have a budget line which reflects the set of feasible baskets where the person just spends all of their income. So this green budget line here, the straight line here, shows the set of feasible consumption bundles where they spend their entire income. And the consumer maximizes their utility by finding the basket of goods that lies on the highest indifference curve that still at least touches the feasible budget line. They're going to find the basket of goods that lies at a point where the budget line and the indifference curves are just tangent to each other. And you can see that that point is illustrated on this graph here. Okay, so now let's look at what happens when the price of one of the goods changes, specifically the price of good X changes. Well, what's going to happen? The budget line is going to rotate out towards the right. It's still going to connect to the Y axis at the same point. And the intuition for that is only the price of good X changed. The price of good Y remains the same, and we assume their income has remained the same. And hence, if they were to spend all of their income on good Y, they would be able to buy just the same number of goods as they were before. So it still connects at the Y-axis at the same point. However, because good X has become relatively cheaper, if they were to spend all of their money on good X, this point here, they'd be able to buy more than they would have previously. Okay. So we could look at what their optimal consumption bundle is after this price change by finding the higher indifference curve that is just tangent to this new budget line. And the point of tangency would be the point that tells us how much of each of the two goods that they're buying, right? So the height of the point tells us how much of good Y, and the horizontal distance of the point tells us how much of good X. Okay, so if we were to compare the horizontal distance of these two points, that would tell us the change in consumption of good X due to the new lower price of good X. So that horizontal difference between the points is the change in the consumption of good X. The vertical difference is the change in consumption of good Y. And you can see in this example, as good X became cheaper, they're buying more of good X and less of good Y. In many cases, we would actually like to split up the total change for a given good into two different effects, one which we're going to call the income effect, and the other which we're going to call the substitution effect. Now, the idea here is that there's sort of two things going on when the price of a good changes, when the price of good X changes. So let's go back for a moment, and let's just look at this problem here. So you can see the white dot indicates the consumption bundle before any prices change. Right, so let's just assume that that's our consumption bundle. And then the price of good X changes goes down so that the new budget line after the price change is given by this red budget line. So that's a new budget line. Now, if they were to still choose the same bundle as before, they would have money left over, right? Because this point falls down and to the left of this red budget line, they'd be able to buy even more of both of the goods. And hence, they are relatively richer or relatively better off. Now, just the fact that they're relatively richer, that itself can have its own impact on the consumption choices for, you know, for this individual, for both good X and good Y. And it's not always necessarily in the same direction, right? If you become relatively richer, that could result in you buying more or less of a given good, depending on the type of good. So for example, as your income goes up, you probably buy more Uber rides. So you're going to buy more Uber rides, but you probably will buy less bus rides, right? In fact, you're substituting Uber rides for bus rides as your income goes up. So we want to understand the change in consumption that's just due to a person being relatively better off. So that's one of the two effects, the income effect. The other effect, the substitution effect, is the change in consumption due to the relative prices of the two goods changing, but not allowing the consumer to be any better or worse off. So it's like basically eliminating the income effect and looking at just what happens due to the relative prices changing, sort of if you were to adjust their income enough so that they're not able to be any happier. Okay, so let's look at those two effects graphically. So how are we going to do that? We're going to want to draw a budget line that has the same slope as the budget line after the price change. Why the same slope? Well, if you recall from one of the previous short videos that I posted, the slope of the budget line is equal to minus 1 times the ratio of the prices, price of good X over price of good Y. So if two lines have the same slope on this graph, that means that, or two budget lines have the same slope, that means that they reflect the same relative prices. But what we're going to do is we're going to take the blue line and we're going to parallel shift it left and right, left or right, just enough so that they're just able to reach the same indifference curve as before any price changes. So that means that they're just able to reach the same level of happiness as they had before the price of good X dropped. So let's illustrate this. So we have this initial consumption basket A. It falls on the indifference curve, which is depicted there. And what we're going to do is we're going to have this hypothetical budget line. It's just what something we're going to use to help solve the problem. It doesn't never actually exist. There is no hypothetical budget line in practice. Like the consumer never has that budget line or that budget. But we're going to construct it to help solve this problem. And as I said, the way we're going to construct it is we're going to shift it, parallel shift, down and to the left far enough so that it just reaches the initial indifference curve. Okay, so you can see that if they ever actually face this hypothetical budget line, they would choose consumption basket B. Now, if we look at the consumption basket A and consumption basket B, they fall on the same indifference curve, so we're not allowing this consumer to be any better or worse off. But there is a change in consumption for both goods because the relative prices has changed. So this hypothetical budget line allows us to see what happens to their consumption if the relative prices change, but they weren't able to be any better off. So the difference, and we can calculate this difference both for good X and good Y, is the change due to just the substitution effect. So in this case, you can see that it results, actually it will always be the case, that they're buying more of the good that became relatively cheaper and less of the other good due to the substitution effect. Okay, so the substitution effect always sort of works in a predictable manner. The income effect is not as straightforward. But let me talk first about how you actually would calculate or see the income effect on this graph. To see the income effect, we're going to compare points B and C. Now remember, I said that the hypothetical budget line, the blue one, and the budget line after the price change, the red one, have the same slope, implying that they reflect the same relative prices. So what is the difference between these two budget lines? The relative price of the goods is not changing, but the red budget line is parallel shifted further out into the right, implying that the consumer can buy more of both of the goods, right? Since the relative prices aren't changing, but the income is changing, the change in consumption that the consumer chooses when they go from this blue budget line to the red budget line reflects just the change in consumption due to them being relatively better off. Okay, so this change, you can look at the change for good X by looking at the horizontal difference between these points, or the difference for good Y by looking at the vertical difference between these points. Those reflect the change in consumption for whichever good due to the income effect, due to them being relatively better off. And it's isolating that income effect separate from this, the effect due to the relative prices changing. So if we look at this, we can see that the total effect is equal to the sum of the substitution effect and the income effect. And you can see for good X that the substitution effect and the income effect work in the same direction. So they're sort of amplifying each other. For good Y, you can see in this example that the substitution effect causes them to buy less of good Y, but the income effect, at least in this example, causes them to buy more of good Y. And so they're sort of working against each other. But still, in this example, the total effect of this price decrease for good X is to reduce the amount of good Y consumed. So this is sort of the setup. I encourage you, if this was fast, to rewatch this lecture and try and make sure that you have a good understanding of this. In the next short video and in a couple of different questions in class, we're going to use the income and substitution effect to help us gain a deeper understanding on a number of different economic problems.